The last one of the three official timers from the PLC Open Standard is the pulse timer, also known as just TP. This timer is used for generating pulses of a specific length. The function block looks like this. So you will see that it has four pins, one input, which takes a Boolean data type, one output, which also takes a Boolean data type, a preset time, which takes a time data type, and elapsed time, which takes also a time data type. The preset time is the length of our pulse. So remember that this is used for generating pulses of a specific length. So the preset time is the length of our pulse. The elapsed time is how long the pulse has been activated for. This is a function diagram of how it works. Let's try to simulate a little bit. I will start by turning on the input. And as you can see, as soon as I turn on the input, the output will also be turned on immediately. The elapsed time, as soon as I turned on the input, also started counting. And when the elapsed time has reached the preset time, so remember the preset time is the length of our pulse. So as soon as that happens, the output will be deactivated again. So you can see what we have generated here through the output is a pulse of a certain length, and that length is our preset time. As soon as I turn off the input again, then the elapsed time will be reset to zero. So we can try again. I'm going to turn on the input, the output turns on immediately, and the elapsed time started to count, because now the pulse is there, and we want to count the length of that pulse. Even if I turn off the input, the elapsed time will still count, because remember, this is used for generating pulses of a specific length. So as soon as the pulse is set, the pulse will be on for that amount of time, no matter what. You can see I can turn on and off the input. Nothing happens before the elapsed time has reached the preset time. So you can see, even though the input is very different, we generated the same nice pulse of the same length both times. Again, I just turn on the input, the output will then generate the pulse of that specific length. Let me illustrate here again how the pulse timer works. We are in Codesys, and as you can see, I dropped in a pulse timer function block here. I just called it timer one, and I gave it one input, and I gave it a preset time of 7 seconds. So remember, this is going to be the length of our pulse. I gave it a variable of a time data type here, just so we can see how long the pulse has been activated for. Remember, this is our elapsed time. I'm gonna log on to the simulation and put the PLC in running mode. And now you can see the input is false, so the output is also false, and the elapsed time is zero. Let me turn on the input and let's see what happens. I'm gonna turn on the input, and you can see, as soon as I turn it on, the elapsed time started to count. And after the 7 seconds, the output was set to false again. So what we got here was a pulse from the moment I turned on the input and 7 seconds. Let's try it again. Turn it to false. And as you can see, it's only when I turn this one to false that the elapsed time is being reset to zero. Let's turn it on again. And you can see it started to count. And even though I turn it off, turn it on again, and turn it off, nothing happens. The same pulse will still be generated here. And the pulse is the length of PT, so 7 seconds. Let's try it one more last time. I'm gonna turn it on. And as you can see, the output is also turned on. And after 7 seconds, it is turned off again. so we will generate a nice pulse here of 7 seconds. This can be very useful if you have a very short signal on the input side here and you want to prolong, or if you have a very long signal here or you want to make it shorter, then you can use the pulse timer for that. That was all I had for now about pulse timers. I hope you guys liked the video and that you've learned something. If you have some further questions about pulse timers or timers in general, feel free to write a comment below. Also, don't forget to click the red button just below this video to subscribe for more videos like this.